The session is being recorded right now, so we are in unit number 6, and we have learned about how to describe our neighborhood using there's or there is and there are, and vocabulary about places. That was lesson A. In lesson B, we learn how to tell the time and to answer questions about it, and how to give the time and how to make questions about the time, and also how to make suggestions with lists. Let's do this, let's do that, let's go home, let's go to the movie, it's an invitation, a suggestion. In lesson C, that was last class, we learned about me too or me neither. That is a confirmation that we are with the same opinion or that we have something in common. And also to say right or I know, to show agreement that we have also the same opinion, that we have the same understanding about a situation or likes or dislikes or of something. Those are the uses of these words. Today, we are going to learn a little bit vocabulary about different places in a city using a guide. A guide is something that has information about a city, how to get places, or recommendations about activities and places to do something. Here, let's continue with the review. Here, there is and there are. There is or there's is used with only one thing. It's for singular nouns. There is a house. There is a building. Or like in the example, there is a boy, an apple, depending on the noun. And you describe places, you describe rooms, you describe cities. For example, in Acapulco, there is an stadium. There is a stadium. The UDA is a stadium. There is. There are many hotels in Acapulco. There are. So you use there are for plurals. More than two things. Two oranges. There are three people. There are six women. There is and there are. Also, we learn some quantifiers, words that are helping us to describe the amount or quantities of things. And a lot of, you can use it with all nouns to talk about large amount or quantity about things. For example, if you are in the market, a lot of people. If you are in, I don't know, maybe in a neighborhood, a lot of houses, a lot of. So when you go to the restaurant, maybe you ask for tortillas and the person says there are a lot of tortillas, a lot of. So you eat a lot of tortillas, a lot of, a big quantity. Some is not a big quantity. It means little or a few, not much. Some in Spanish, algo o algunos. Some is used when you are talking about not many things, not a lot of things. Some can be used maybe with 10, 5, 2 or 3 things that you have. Some, you can use it when you have some money, not much, but some. Maybe when you have a homework, not a lot of homework, maybe only 2 or 3. You say, I have some homework. Some friends, some means a little or a few, not a big quantity, a small quantity. And also we learn about a couple. A couple in a translation or in Spanish means un par, but in English, people tend to use a couple to indicate something between 2 or 5 things. So for example, here in my hand, I have a couple of cell phones, only 2. But if I have more, 3, 4, 5, I can say I have a couple of cell phones, but only up to 5. No more than that. A couple. A couple is used to refer about people, buildings, houses, or places. Also, we learn about the position of the adjectives, how to use them. Adjectives come before nouns. They come before nouns. So, for example, in Spanish, we place the adjective at the end, la casa bonita. But in English, we don't say the house beautiful. That is incorrect. We say the beautiful house or the expensive car, not the car expensive. That is incorrect. So this is one position. There is another position of the adjectives. But here, first, we need to learn that the adjectives that describe something, they go before the noun. So if you describe a house, the beautiful house. If you describe a beach, the beautiful beach, beautiful beach. If the beach is large, the large beach. Large is the adjective. An adjective is a word that describes something, in this case, a noun. So, and then we practice a little bit with there is and there are, using a lot of, some or a couple, and also using these words that are, I don't remember the name of these, but these are a or an or the. There are, I don't remember the word, but you use them when it's in general. A or an means uno or una, doesn't talk about something specific. The is talking about something specific. I'm sorry, guys, but I don't remember the name of these two words, but you have learned about them. So a is used for a consonant sound and an is for a vowel sound. And where is nothing, there's zero, so we use no. For example, in the fridge, you open the fridge, no apples. Oh, there are no apples. If you have two, oh, there are a couple of apples or some apples. If the fridge is full of apples, you say, oh, there are a lot of apples. So these are the words that we use to practice. For example, here, what can we say about this image with there is or there are? What can you say?
There are.
There are what?
There are a lot of houses.
A lot of houses. Plural. There are. Very good, Fatima. And what about this? It's only one.
There is.
There is.
There is a park.
There is a park. What about the pirate here?
There is a pirate.
There is a pirate. What about the map here?
There is a map.
There is a map. What about the telephone booth?
There is a telephone.
There is a what about the palm trees?
There are
palm trees. Very good. What about cars?
There are a car.
There are a car. Or there are. There are some cars. There are a lot of cars, maybe, but plural. What about two flags?
Couple.
Uh-huh. There are or there is?
There are a couple red flags.
Of red flags. Very good. There is and there are. Very good. Here for also in unit number, in lesson C, you know, lesson B, we learn about telling the time. So we ask about different events. For example, here I have an event. This is a basketball game. So if I ask you, what time is the basketball game? What is the answer? The basketball game is at 10 a.m. Right? What time? What time is the basketball game? So, for example, in the next one, Fatima, what time is the school dinner?
It's 8 p.m.
At 8 p.m. At. Carolina, what time is the movie or the movie night? What time is the movie night?
At 8 p.m.
At 9 p.m. Very good. And finally, Fatima, what time is the concert?
At 8 o'clock.
This is how we ask about different events. And finally, in the last class, we learn about the uses of me too or me neither. Me too, me neither, these are affirmations of something that you are in the same idea or the same way with another person. Means that you are the same with the same opinion. So me too, me neither are affirmations. Affirmations for something positive, me too. Or affirmations with that something is negative. For example, I like dogs, me too. Here we have the affirmation about something that I am the same with the person, me too. Or I don't like cats, me neither. It's an affirmation that I have the same idea about cats. Me too, it's the same idea about I like dogs. So me too, me neither are words that help me to say that I am the same with the same opinion or the same idea about something that it's been said. Me too, me did. And also we learn about the word right or I know to give the meaning or the idea that I have something in common. Okay, now let's do something here. Before we continue, I have an exercise for you guys about telling the time. Remember the question, what time is it? Remember the question? This is the question. What time is it? So what time is it now, right here? What time is it? To tell the time, we just say it's and then the time. It's
11:25.
Okay, so in this case, I want to ask you using this watch, you see, different hours, and we can play about the time. So, what time is it here?
It is 10.
It is 10.
20:25.
Exactly. It's 10:25. Fatima, what time is it here?
It's 9:29.
Okay. Well, Fatima, that is wrong. 9:29 is here. The long arm points the minutes. The short arm points the hour. So this is 9:29. Okay? So the long arm of the watch gives you the minutes. The short arm gives you the hours. So, for example, right here, we have 11. 11 what?
11:40.
What time is it? It's 11, the hour, 40, the minute. So, Carolina, what time is it?
It's 11:05. 12, 5 minutes. 12,
exactly. It's 12.
5.
Remember, you mention this zero using the word O. It's 12:05. Let me remind you the exercise right here. Remember this page? Right here we have, oh yes, it's right here. It's 2:05. The zero, you say the zero by using the word O. So it's 10:05 or 2:05 in this case. Or the other way, it's 5 after 2. Okay? Let's go back to the exercise one more time. What time is it? Fatima, what time is it?
It's 1:45.
A quarter to one, that is correct. Carolina, what time is it?
It's 11. It's quarter after 11.
Before is used when you are almost at the next hour. So before 12. When you are moving in the other direction, for example, right here, now it's a quarter, and you can use the word after, because the minutes are after 12. So you say before or after. In this case, when the time is going on the direction of 12, right here, passing 12, you say after. When the time is moving towards 12, almost getting to the number 12, you say before. One more time, let's practice. Remember, practice makes perfect. So, what time is it here, Fatima?
It's
25. Carolina, what time is it here?
It's 10 after 11
is like here.
Oh.
So this is before after 11. Exactly. Before. So yeah. When it's almost the next hour, here is 11 o'clock. Remember o'clock? So it's 10 minutes to 11. Here, now we have the time 11, but it's 10 minutes after 11. So what time is it here?
2:20.
You can say it's 2:20 or 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes after 2. One more time. This is for Fatima. What time is it here, Fatima?
It's 8:35.
It's 8:35. Very good. Carolina, this is for you.
It's 10 before 3?
Exactly. 10 before 3. Very good. Now, what time is it here, Fatima?
It's 12 o'clock.
12 o'clock. Very good. What about this, Carolina? What time is it here?
It's 2 p.m. What is it?
Or 2 p.m. Or?
Or 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock. Exactly. Very good. Yes, so you were right. Is it difficult? Was it difficult? ¿Estuvo difícil?
No, teacher,
no. Just practice, yes. So, well, you can use this web page. I'm going to paste this one for you in the chat. Maybe you can practice a little bit. Let me put it for you. It's a nice way to practice. It's right on the chat, so you can change the time here. And you can ask yourself, what time is it? So, for example, right here, it's at the half. So it's 3:30 or 3:30 or 30 minutes after 3. Many ways to say the time. Okay, that was lesson B. In lesson C, we learned about me too. Me too is used to show that we have something in common, that we are the same. So here, I have an exercise. Here, it says, in part D, write me too or me neither to complete the conversations. Remember, me too or me neither are used when we have the same idea. Me neither, me too are used when we have the same opinion. So me too is for an affirmative, for something that is positive. Me neither is an affirmation for something that is negative. So I want you to help me by placing the correct sentence here or the correct answer into the correct position. For example, number one is an example. I am really hungry. The answer, yeah. It's positive, me too. For number two, it says, I don't have a lot of money with me. I don't have money. I don't have a lot of money. Is this something positive or this is something negative?
This negative.
Negative. So what is the correct one? Me too or me neither?
Me neither.
Exactly. So what you are going to do is place the correct answer on the line. Okay? Now, Carolina, you have the control of my mouse.
Okay.
To do number three.
Teacher, una pregunta.
Yes, of course, Fátima.
Siempre cuando sea la oración negativa, ¿la respuesta va a ser me neither? ¿O depende de la situación?
Depending on the situation, for example, remember, me neither is that you are the same with something that is negative. For example, without money. No money is not positive. No money, you need more money. So it's not something. Let me help you, Carolina. Don't move the mouse. Don't worry. Don't worry. No lo muevas. A ver, déjame ayudarte.
Thank you.
No te preocupes. Sí. Sí, más o menos podría ser así, ¿cómo se llama? Fátima. Ahí cuando se ponga así, Carolina, ya lo puedes mover.
Cuando
se ponga la estrellita. So, yes, Fátima, when something is negative and you agree with that, me neither is more common. Very good. So, I never go to expensive restaurants. That is negative, so me neither. Now, it's your turn, Fatima. You have the control. Remember, wait for the cross. So for number four, it says, sometimes I eat fast food at sometimes I eat at fast food places. The answer, as you can see, is yeah. Exactly, exactly, with the cross. Perfect. Yeah, me too. Very good. Excellent job. Now let's do number five with Carolina. Carolina, I'm going to give you control right now. So number five says, I don't often have lunch at home. Wait for the cross. Exactly right there. Very good. Me neither. Okay, good exercise. Now, Fatima, do the last one. You have the control now, Fatima. Excellent. I really like outdoor cafes. Oh, me too. So let's practice a little bit. I am going to be student A, and you ladies are going to be student B. So let's practice one by one, okay? This column is for Carolina, and mm-hmm. this column is for Fatima. Okay. Carolina, yeah. Just read the example. Okay. Follow the conversation. For example, number one, I'm really hungry.
Yeah, me too.
Very good. Fatima, sometimes I eat at fast food places.
Yeah, me too.
Carolina, I don't have a lot of money with me.
Me neither.
Fatima, I don't often have lunch at home.
Me neither,
okay. Carolina, I never go to expensive restaurants.
No, me neither.
Me neither. Fatima, I really like outdoor cafes.
Oh, me too.
Very good. So that's the way you have the same opinion of the same idea. Here, we also learn about right and I know. Here, we are going to have a listening about this conversation strategy. Also remember that we use let's to give an opinion or a suggestion or an invitation to do something. I am going to play an audio, and here you are going to help me to decide or listening where these people decide to go. So here we have three conversations, Jason and Sophia, and they are talking. Maybe they are going to decide to go to a shop, to shop something, or to eat. Let me play the audio. You ladies, please help me by listening to say if they are going to shop something or to eat. Here is the audio.
Page 59.
Can you hear the audio?
Yes, teacher.
Very good. Now listen.
3. Listening and strategies. Let's go there. A. Listen. Where do the people decide to go? 1. Jason and Sophia.
You know, I need some new sunglasses.
Yeah, me too. My sunglasses are really old.
So let's go to the mall. There's a big department store there. They have sunglasses, I think.
You know, I don't really like big department stores. They're always so busy.
Actually, there's a store over there, next to the gym.
Okay, let's try there.
Okay, conversation one. Sophia and Jason are talking about sunglasses. Are they going to the mall? ¿Van a ir a un centro comercial?
Yes.
Okay. Are they going to eat?
No.
So the answer is letter A, right here. So they decide to go shopping, to shop something. They are going to shop glasses. Let's listen again to conversation. And please notice how they use let's to give a suggestion.
Well, I need some new sunglasses.
Yeah, me too. My sunglasses are really old.
So let's go to the mall. There's a big department store there.
Let's go to the mall. That's an invitation, a suggestion to do something. Let's go to the mall.
They have sunglasses, I think.
You know, I don't really like big department stores.
I don't really like big department stores. The lady says she doesn't like big department stores.
They're always so busy.
Because they're so busy means there are a lot of people.
Actually, there's a store over there.
There's a store over there. They are using, or in this case, Jason is using theirs. There's a store over there.
Next to the gym.
Next to the gym.
Okay, let's try there.
Let's try there. Okay, that was conversation number one. Now, in conversation number two, they are choosing a place for two reasons. One is correct, to have fun or to study. Listen to the conversation about these two people, Tyler and Jen.
Two, Tyler and Jen.
I really need a break from work.
Oh, I know. I'm tired.
Well, I have an idea. Let's do something fun after work.
Yeah, let's go out somewhere. Do you know any good places?
Well, there's a new club near here. There's a jazz band tonight, I think.
You know, I'm not a big fan of jazz. I mean, it's okay, but...
Well, what about the rock club? It's a fun place to go. I'm a big fan of rock. I love rock music.
Me too. That's a great idea.
The bands usually start around 7 o'clock.
Okay. That sounds perfect. Let's do it.
Let's do it. Are they choosing a place to have fun or to study?
To have fun.
That is correct. Yes, they are choosing a place to have fun. Let's listen again because they are choosing a space to have fun, but what kind of a space?
I know. I'm tired.
Well, I have an idea. Let's do something fun after work.
Yeah, let's go out somewhere. Do you know any good places?
Well, there's a new club near here. There's a jazz band tonight, I think.
You know, I'm not a big fan of jazz. I mean, it's okay, but...
Well, what about the rock club? It's a fun place to go. I'm a big fan of rock. I love rock music.
Me too. That's a great idea.
The bands usually start around 7 o'clock.
Okay. That sounds perfect. Let's do it.
Okay. Where are they going? Maybe to have fun at the beach, at the movies? Where are they going? Carolina, Fatima, they choose a
place. To eat.
To eat? No, well, we are in conversation number two. Tyler and Jen, they choose a place to have fun. But what kind of place? ¿Qué tipo de lugar escogieron? We are in conversation number two.
Donde escuchan música rock o algo así.
Exactly, exactly. A place to listen to music, a bar maybe. Okay, now we are going to listen about Michael and Anna, and they are choosing a place maybe to exercise or maybe to eat. Listen to the conversation.
Three, Michael and Anna.
I'm kind of hungry. How about you?
Yeah, me too. Do you know any good places to eat?
Well, there are a lot of nice restaurants around here.
Right, but I, don't have a lot of money with me.
No, me neither. Let's just go to a fast food place.
You know, I never eat fast food. I mean, I don't really like it.
Right. Well, there's an outdoor cafe over there. It's not very expensive.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I go there a lot.
Okay. Well, let's eat there.
Okay, for number three, Anna, Michael and Anna choose a place to exercise or to eat. Carolina.
Exercise?
No. Oh. To eat.
Eat. To eat.
Listen again.
Oh. Page 59. Page 50.
Me too. Do you know?
And Anna.
They are hungry.
I'm kind of hungry.
Kind of hungry.
How about you?
Yeah, me too. Do you know any good places to eat?
Well, there.
Any good places to eat?
There are a lot of nice restaurants around here.
Right, but.
A lot of restaurants.
Don't have a lot of money with.
I don't have a lot of money
with me.
No, me neither.
Me neither. Two part of pobretones. Eh? A couple of pobretones. No money, hungry, and no money.
Let's just go to a fast food place.
A fast food place like McDonald's, maybe? Maybe tacos de canasta. Not expensive, kind of cheap. Or maybe some picadas over there in Acapulco.
You know, I never eat fast food.
I never eat fast food, though, the lady says.
I mean, I don't really like it.
Right.
I don't really like it. And he says, right.
Well, there's an outdoor cafe over there. It's not very expensive.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I go there a lot.
Okay, well, let's eat there.
Okay, so they are choosing a place to eat. In the next activity, we have also three statements from the conversations. And here, you need to choose if you are the same or different. First, you need to check the column that you agree with and then complete the response. For example, if you are the same, you check here. If you are different, you don't check it. Here, if you are different. Here, if you are the same. Okay, for example, let's listen statement number one.
Page.
We are going to do it together.
59. 3. Listening and strategies. Let's go there. B. Listen to three statements from the conversations. Are you the same or different?
That's the question. Are we the same or are we different? If we are the same, we check here. If we are different, we check here. And after we check, we complete the response. Let's do number one.
One.
You know, I don't really like big department stores. They're always so busy.
Okay. I don't really like big department stores. They are always busy. Are you the same or are you different?
Same.
In the case of Fatima, they are the same. Me neither. I don't like what? I don't like big department stores. That's the complete answer. I don't like big department stores. Okay. So, for in your case, Carolina, do you agree with this? Are you the same, Carolina? Or you're different? You like many people on the store?
No le entendí muy bien, teacher.
No te preocupes. Dice, no me gustan los centros comerciales porque siempre están abarrotados de gente. Y dice Fátima, me neither. I don't like big department store. Because she is the same. Porque ella piensa igual.
Okay.
Me neither for something that is negative. Me too for something that is positive. In your case, Carolina, do you like big department stores or not? Crowdy, busy department store. Que estén llenos de gente. ¿Te gusta o no te gusta?
No.
Okay, so me neither. I don't like big department store. Si nos hubiera gustado, hubiéramos dicho, really? And the answer will be, I like big department stores. The same. Let's do number two. Here, we are listening to a statement and we need to answer if we are the same or different. Tenemos que contestar si tenemos la misma opinión o diferente. Number two, let's listen to the conversation. Vamos a escuchar esta conversación.
Two.
I'm a big fan of rock.
I'm a big fan of rock.
I love rock music.
I love rock music. What about you, Carolina? Me too? Or I don't like it?
Me too.
What about you, Fatima?
Me too.
Me too. So, I really like what? I really like rock and roll. That's the answer. I really like rock and roll. Because we have the same opinion. We are the same. If we were different, si hubiéramos sido diferentes, yeah, I don't like rock and roll. So let's listen number three now.
Three.
You know, I never eat fast food.
You know, I never eat fast food, never.
I mean, I don't really like it.
I don't really like it. What about you, Carolina?
I'm different.
Okay. So in this case, really, I think, what would you say about fast food? ¿Qué dirías de la comida rápida? I think...
Ella dice que no le gusta la comida rápida. I did the same.
You're the same. So I'm in this case, okay, you're the same. Yeah. I know you will say, I don't like fast food. What about you, Fatima?
Same.
You're the same? Really? You don't eat bolillo con relleno?
Que si no me gusta la comida rápida.
Uh-huh.
No, sí me gusta.
So in this case, ¿qué pensarías de la comida rápida? I think fast food is tasty. Está sabrosa.
Es muy rica, ya.
Bueno, dependiendo, ¿no? Si son picaditas, si son tacos de canasta, si son bolillo con relleno. Ahí sí le entraban las dos, ¿verdad?
Unas tortas.
Exactly. In Mexico City, torta de bolillo. Here in Querétaro, they say the name is guajolotes. So you put a bolillo and you put a tamal in the middle of the bolillo. ¿Cómo ven? Tan locos, ¿verdad? No manches. Bolillo con tamal. Okay. So this is to practice a little bit about if we have the same opinion or we are different. So now we are going to go to lesson D. In lesson D, we are going to learn a little bit about vocabulary of places in a neighborhood. Here the title, it says, A Neighborhood Guide. What means guide? ¿Qué será guide in Spanish?
Guía.
Exactly.
Guía.
So a neighborhood guide is like a magazine that you can read and see about places. There are some guides like a magazine, but nowadays you can find a guide on the net. So for example, here, what can you see here? ¿Qué pueden ver aquí?
Una guía turística.
Exactly. It's a tourist guide or a neighborhood guide that is on the net. It's a web page. So you can find a lot of information of different places. So let me show you something about different guides. For example, New York. Let's type New York and I type the word guide. And here I can find many things or a lot of information about New York. So I can explore neighborhoods and I can have some ideas about different places, what to do. Maybe some place, maybe places to visit, places to eat, art galleries, and many things that I can find in, for example, in New York, in this case, by using this guide. So this is the Bronx. It's a neighborhood in New York. So I can have a lot of information of places, places to eat, places to visit, and so on. So this is a guide. In this case, we have a guide of a village. And it's also a place near New York. Un lugar cerca de New York. What is the name of the place?
Manhattan.
Exactly. Manhattan's Greenwich Village. That's the name. And here we have the title. What is the title of the page?
The village.
In Spanish, La Villa. And here, this webpage is talking about places to visit, things to do in the village. So first, letter A, before we go to the reading. It says, do you know any neighborhoods with these things? Tell the class. We have five vocabulary words. Number one. What is unusual boutiques? ¿Qué será unusual boutiques?
Boutique, tiendas de ropa.
Exactly. Not very common boutiques, no muy comunes. Unusual, inusuales. Number two, expensive jewelry stores. Jewelry.
Joyerías de alta calidad, así caras.
Exactly. So there are places where you can buy rings or a necklace, but very expensive. Comedy clubs.
Comedy club de comedia. Mm-hmm.
Exactly, comedy clubs. Places where you can go, like, I don't know if you know Francisco Escamilla. ¿Han visto a Francisco Escamilla? ¿Sí lo conocen?
No.
Yes. Fátima, ¿cómo es posible que conozcas a Paco Escamilla? Bueno.
Lo he escuchado.
Francisco Escamilla is very popular. He does comedy stand. Él hace comedia en clubs. Vamos a ponerlo. Francisco Escamilla, dije que se llama. Aquí está. Paco Escamilla. And he does comedy like this. For example, he's standing and he's talking and he makes jokes. And this is like a bar. Y este es como un bar. So he's talking and making jokes about people, politics, you name it. lo que sea. So this is like a comedy stand, and in the book it says that it's a comedy club. Okay, Carolina?
Okay, teacher.
Very good. Poetry readings. What means poetry?
And lectura de poesía.
Exactly. Where can you do this activity? ¿Dónde puede hacer esta actividad?
En teatros,
maybe. Maybe in a theater, okay.
Park.
In a park, yes. And finally, art galleries.
Galerías de arte.
Exactly. Do we have art galleries in Acapulco? ¿Lo tenemos galerías de arte en Acapulco?
Sí, yes, sí, la, la exposición de la Casa de la Cultura.
Yes, very good. There are some arts over there, maybe paintings, sculptures, many things. So I want you to help me reading this guide, this description of these places. If you find a new word, let me know so I can highlight the word. For example, village, or maybe Greenwich. These are the names of the place. So if you find a new word, please let me know. I'm going to start the reading and you guys are going to help me. Can you see my screen? ¿Sí pueden ver mi pantalla?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, because I want you to help me with the reading, porque quiero que me ayuden con la lectura. Okay. Here, let me start. And then I'm going to point out where you are going to continue, okay?
Yes.
Number one, it says, welcome to Manhattan's Greenwich Village. This artsy neighborhood has something for everyone. There are outdoor cafes, great theaters, music and comedy clubs, interesting stores, restaurants, and beautiful parks. Any new word here? ¿Alguna palabra nueva aquí?
Artsy.
Repeat after me. Artsy.
Artsy.
Artsy. Artística. Esta colonia artística. This artsy neighborhood. Okay. Now, here we have some four headings. Aquí tenemos cuatro encabezados. Different streets, different places. Carolina, can you please help me with this heading right here?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, thank you.
Bleecker Street Shopping.
Mm-hmm.
Window shopping of divisive streets is found. There are some wonderful stores and unusual boutiques. It's a great place to buy books, closet, and generally stores are usually open between 11 o'clock and 8 o'clock.
Very good. Busy. Busy means ocupado o lleno. Busy. Boutiques, stores, tiendas, boutiques. Any other word that is new for you, Fatima, here? Or Carolina, sorry?
No, teacher.
No? Jewelry, joyería.
Joyería.
And this is very good. Between.
Entre.
It's a preposition that helps us to talk about, in this case, a schedule. Nos ayuda a hablar de un horario. Okay. Between 11 and 8. O sea que está abierto entre ese horario. Between. Remember this word. Okay, between. Fatima, can you help me with Washington Square Park?
There are a lot of free events in this beautiful park. Concerts, movies, poetry, readings, and more. It's also the perfect place to just sit, enjoy some quiet time, and maybe play a chess game. It's open from early morning to 1 o'clock.
Very good. Any new word here? ¿Alguna palabrita nueva? These are the activities. Concerts, movies, poetry readings, lectura de poemas. So it's something like in the park, maybe a person sits, he has a table, una persona se siente en el parque, tiene una mesita, and he starts reading poetry, and people are listening to him. Y mientras empieza a leer, se junta gente y lo escucha leer las poesías. It's an activity that you just do it in some places. Quiet time. What is chess game? ¿Qué será chess game?
Juego de ajedrez.
Exactly. And also, please let me point out that here we have another preposition, from. From is also used to give the idea that something starts from some point in time to another. Aquí inicia desde, ¿desde qué? Early morning to 1 p.m. From and to. These two words are connected. Estas dos palabritas están conectadas. It's open from to. Remember these words too. Acuérdense de estas dos palabritas. Carolina, is there any other question, Carolina and Fátima, from these two readings, de estas dos?
No, quisiera traducir la parte donde yo leí, en la parte, en el encabezado, se diría la calle de
compras.
De compras,
Bleecker Street Shopping. Compras en la calle Bleecker.
Y el otro sería el parque.
Washington Square Washington. Park. Uh-huh. El parque de la calle Washington. Muy bien.
Gracias.
No, no worries. Thank you. Fátima, can you read the next heading and then the reading, please? Fátima.
Live music in the beach. ¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Very good, thank you. Village.
Village.
Repeat after me. Village.
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 Live music in the village. Mm-hmm. There is a great music vibe in the village with street perform. All record store and the village famous jazz club, such as Fat Cat and the Blue Note. For more information about shows, visit the Gotham Jazz website at www.gothamjazz.com.
Very good, very good. Is there any new word here? ¿Alguna palabra nueva? Live music in the village. There is a great...
Perform, teacher, ¿cómo se traduce perform?
Performers, perform. Intérpretes.
Oh,
intérpretes. By vibra, ¿sí? Fátima, you were saying something, ¿vas a decir algo también? Such as, tal como, dice, there's a great music vibe in the village with street performers. Street performers like this one, they are playing their instrument on the street. Street performers son aquellos que tocan un instrumento cuando están en la calle, y ya ven que muchos lados lo hacen, ¿no? Street performers are people that are playing an instrument, maybe in the park, maybe on the street, and they are getting tips from people. So they put a coin, maybe a dollar, something like that. And it says, and the village famous jazz clubs. Están hablando de clubs famosos, such as Fat Cat. Fat Cat is the name of the club. So the Fat Cat Club and the Blue Note, two famous clubs in the village. Any other word? www.gothamjazz.com. Okay. No questions, no more words. Carolina, can you help me with this one?
No, todo bien, teacher.
Okay, can you help me with the last one, please?
Teacher, la palabra vide, ¿cómo
vibe.
Se traduce? Bye.
Vibras.
Vibra. Oh.
Son como las buenas vibras.
Okay.
Great music vibes. Vibras de música excelente in the village.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
No worry. Thank you. And finally, please, Fatima, help me to read this one and the last reading.
Art in the village.
Sorry, I say Fatima. I mean Carolina. Sorry, Fatima. Thank you, Fatima. My mistake.
Art the village. The village is fond of art, and it's not just in the galleries. Check out this storefront covered in case. Be sure to go to the Forbes Gallery, the exhibit changes throughout the years, and there is always something new to see. The galleries are open Tuesday from Saturday, and admission is free.
Okay, very good. It says the village is full of art, and it's not just the galleries, meaning that you can find art in the galleries, but not only the galleries. Look at the store here. Vean la tienda aquí. A ver si no se mejora mucho la imagen. But the idea is that all this decoration is made of keys. Toda esa decoración está hecha de llaves. Todo esto que se ve aquí is made of keys, está hecho de llaves. Dice, be sure to go to the Forbes Gallery. Be sure. Asegúrense de ir a la Galería Forbes. Dice, the exhibits change throughout the year. In this case, we have another word. Throughout means that the exhibitions or the exhibits, los exhibidores cambian. A través del año, todo el año. Throughout the year, puede ser throughout the year, throughout the week, throughout the month, throughout the day, a través del día. It's an expression that helps us to tell that something is occurring in a period of time. A day, a week, a month, a year, throughout, a través de. And there is always something new to see. The galleries are open again, another word, Tuesday through Saturday. Las galerías están abiertas
de martes a sábado.
Y nosotros le ponemos la palabra de martes a sábado. De a. Through no es lo mismo que throughout. Okay. ¿Qué será admission?
Entrada.
Free. The
admission
is free, so you don't pay. Now let's go for the activity here. Here it says, read the article again. Lee el artículo otra vez. Are these statements true or false? T for true, F for false. I want you to help me decide if number one is true. For example, Bleecker Street is a great place to go window shopping. Es un buen lugar para ir de compras, de window shopping. Window shopping es cuando pues estás viendo los artículos detrás de la ventana. Window shopping. So, number one.
Cuando nada más vas a ver y no a comprar.
Window shopping. Exactly. Para ir a curiosear. So, number one, true or false?
True.
Yes, it's true. Washington Square Park opens at 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, true.
Opens. El parque Washington abre a la 1 de la mañana.
True.
It says
false.
It's open from early morning to one. Está abierto desde temprano, pero no dice la hora. Number three. Washington Square Park has free galleries. Washington Square Park has free galleries. ¿Hay galerías de arte en el Washington Square Park?
False.
False. That is correct. This is false. Next one. Can you read number four, Fátima?
www.lolo.completo.
Sí, por favor.
www.goddamnjazz.com is a website with information on jazz club.
True or false?
True.
True. Carolina, can you read number five?
The Forbes galleries are expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, true.
Check the information.
Okay. False.
Why is false? Because the admission is free. ¿Por qué es falso? Porque la admisión es gratuita. Okay. Okay, now let's go to the next page. Talk about exciting places. Here, what can you see in this page? ¿Qué pueden ver en esta página? What is the people doing in different... in this
park.
In there, we are looking at the park. There what is, about you?
There is a shop.
A shop, maybe a mall.
Not,
park.
Concert.
Museum.
A museum, yes. Okay, it says, answer the question below and discuss your ideas. I agree on the best places. Talking about Acapulco. Pensando en Acapulco. Number one. And you tell me, ladies, what's a great place to shop? ¿Cuál es un lugar bueno de compras? Think about Acapulco.
Galerías Diana.
Okay, Galerías Diana.
Galerías Acapulco.
Okay.
Islas Galerías, Shopping
Galerías. Exactly,
Galería.
Galerías en la isla.
Island.
Okay. What about a good place to find unusual clothes? Un lugar para encontrar ropa inusual. In Acapulco. A good place to find unusual clothes in Acapulco. Clothes. Repeat after me. Clothes.
Clothes.
Clothes means vestuario.
Ropa. Inusual, ¿qué significa, teacher?
Usual quiere decir usual. Unusual, inusual. Is there a place in Acapulco where you can find? Well, maybe Liverpool, okay.
Hay ciertos puestos de ropa, ¿cómo se dice? Vintage.
Vintage o vintage.
Ajá, exacto.
Where can you find them? ¿Dónde los encuentras?
Donde hay muchos mariachis. No me acuerdo cómo se llama. Es donde está el acabús, fuera del acabús y todo eso.
Okay. Question number three. What's a fun place to go window shopping?
Galería Siena.
Mm-hmm.
Galería Siena en Islas.
La Isla Mall. Okay. Now think about Acapulco. Is there an artsy neighborhood? ¿Hay alguna colonia artística?
Mm.
No.
No, I don't think so.
No.
Is there a beautiful park? How park. Many parks do you know in Acapulco?
Papagayo Park.
Papagayo Park.
¿Cómo se llama? ¿Botánica?
Ok, yes, in la, por la Loyola, ¿no?
Ajá.
Okay. That's a beautiful place. Okay, now, question number one from picture, well, from this area. Where's the best outdoor cafe? Do you like to drink coffee? ¿Les gusta ir al café? Is
yeah.
there an outdoor cafe that you yeah. like? Which yeah. one, Carolina?
Yes, teacher. Es muy famoso el café
Wadi. Yes.
Muy.
Right there at the center.
Y pues muy famoso por los Starbucks, ¿no?
Yeah, yes, of course.
Sanborns Café.
Sanborns Café, a good place to. It's not an outdoor, but you can have coffee or café over there. There is a café on La Costera Miguel Alemán. Near of Copacabana Center. Ahí por donde está el centro de eventos Copacabana. There is, hay un cafecito ahí afuera. No me acuerdo cómo se llama. Pero
no.
Nice place.
Bueno.
Where's an unusual building? ¿Hay un edificio inusual en Acapulco? Where's an unusual,
yes.
unusual
building? Yes, yes. Hay un edificio nuevo, bueno, no tan nuevo, que tiene ya como 5 o 6 años, que nunca lo han utilizado, que es autosustentable, pero sin utilizarse. No sé cómo.
El edificio inteligente, ¿no?
Yes,
it's near the Copacabana
uh-huh,
Convention right. Center, y está cerquita del centro de convenciones de Copacabana.
Sí,
it's unusual because it's open. Está muy oh. inusual porque está abierto, todo se ve, ¿no?
Yes,
yes, that's a good one, yes. Also, I have heard that some people find the Acapulco Plaza, or now is Crown Plaza Acapulco, or Houghton Acapulco, the shape of that building very, very strange. Y algunos que encuentran el hotel, vamos a ver si lo busco, el Acapulco Plaza, un oh. hotel medio raro, ah, por la forma que tiene. Ahora
sí.
se llama Hudson.
Hudson, yes.
You see the shape, ¿ven la forma del hotel? Uh-huh. Vamos a ver, sí. vamos a ver, aquí está. This has a funny shape, tiene una forma rara.
Sí.
It's a nice hotel. It used to be one hotel, era un hotel las tres torres, ahora este es, se dividió, pero bueno.
Uh-huh.
It has a funny shape. And finally, what's a popular club in Acapulco? ¿Cuál es un club popular en Acapulco? Fátima, tú no sabes de esto todavía.
Baby.
Baby. Okay.
Baby.
What's a good place for live music? Un lugar bueno para música en vivo. Live el, music.
El que está al lado de del se me olvidó el nombre.
Del Bungee.
No, el centro de Acapulco, no, el donde hacen los el la feria de fin de año. El forum.
Forum, okay. A good place to see art exhibits.
La Casa de la Cultura.
Okay, could be.
O el Fuerte de San Diego.
Yes, there is a mask museum. Ahí el Museo de la Máscara. Very good. Well, here, I want you to help me now here. Before we go to the writing, it's a complicated issue. But here in part B, it says read the help note and then circle the prepositions in the neighborhood guide below. Here, it's a little guide about Wilson Park. This is a description about a place. And the reading is using several prepositions, like the ones are that are right here. These are all prepositions. Can you find more prepositions in the reading about Wilson Park? Let me help you with this one. Wilson Park. Wilson Park is a beautiful park on Green Street in Fairview. It's a great place to play sports. There's a soccer field, a couple of baseball fields, and some free tennis courts. There are free concerts at the stadium on the weekends. They start at 5 p.m. There's also a nice cafe, and it's open from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Tuesday through Sunday. Now, can you point out the prepositions, please? On is one. Is there another preposition?
In.
In, very good.
On the weekend.
On, very good. On the weekend.
To play sport.
To, very good.
Of play sport.
Baseball fields. But we don't have the preposition of here.
Between.
No, that is not a preposition.
Tuesday.
Exactly. Through Sunday. From to
At the stadium.
Yes, Fatima.
Teacher, ¿cómo se traduce la palabra strong? Entre, no, ¿verdad? Donde dice es Tuesday, strong.
True. Tuesday, true, Sunday. Se traduce como de.
De.
Martes a domingo.
True.
O a través, true, también se puede hacer. But these prepositions are used in different ways. A estas preposiciones se están utilizando aquí de diferente manera. Let's go one by one. Vamos a ir una por una. Here, on. Wilson Park is on Green Street. So we use on when we are talking about something using a street name. Estamos hablando de on, no de sobre. For example, the cell phone is on the table. El celular está sobre la mesa. No, on here is talking about a preposition of place, but referring a street, pero refiriéndose a una calle. So, for example, if I ask you, where is Galerías Acapulco? The answer is, it's on Costera Miguel Alemán. On, because we are using on to talk about something that is on a street. Algo que está sobre la calle. If I ask you, where is no, this is not what I want. Right here. This is Papagayo Park. Can you see Papagayo Park here?
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. If I ask you, where is Central de Autobuses Estrella Blanca? Using on, usando on.
Avenue Cuauhtémoc.
On Cuauhtémoc Avenue. That's the answer. Si utilizamos on, we used on to refer something that it's on the street. Algo que está cerca o más bien sobre una calle. On. ¿Sí? On the street. One more. Vamos a usar otra. Ahorita que aparezca. Here's, aquí está Acapulco. This is the Papagayo Park. This is Estrella Blanca. If I ask you, si les pregunto, A ver, vamos a ver. Where is Vicente Guerrero Hospital? This is Vicente Guerrero Hospital. Right here. Where is Vicente Guerrero Hospital? ¿Cómo se llama esta calle?
Ruiz Cortines.
Oh, okay, so Carolina, where is Vicente Guerrero Hospital?
Ruiz Cortines on Ruiz Cortines Avenue.
Exactly, on Ruiz Cortines Avenue. Thank you very much. So let me find another street. Vamos a ver otra calle. Ah, right here. Aquí está. Do you know this street? ¿Saben cómo se llama esa calle?
No.
No.
Ejido.
No. Exactly. Ejido. So, if I ask you, Fátima, where is Farmacia Guadalajara?
On Ejido Street.
On Ejido Street or on Ejido Avenue. So use on to talk about places on the street. Okay? On, that's the first one. In. In. We use in when we are talking about something inside of a bigger place. We use in cuando hablamos de algo que está dentro de un lugar más grande. Especially maybe cities, for example. Where is Avenida Ejido? ¿Dónde está la Avenida Ejido? In
Acapulco.
In Acapulco. Where is Avenida Ejido? In Acapulco. Where is Acapulco? ¿Dónde está Acapulco?
In Guerrero.
In Guerrero. Right here. Where is Guerrero?
In Mexico.
In Mexico. Where is Mexico?
In America.
In North America. In North America. Where is North America? In American continent, en el continente americano. Where is the American continent? In the planet.
Planet.
In planet Earth. Where is planet Earth? ¿Dónde está el planeta Tierra?
En el sistema solar.
In the solar system. And where is the solar system, Fátima?
In the universe.
In the universe. That is correct. Well, first is in the galaxy. Primero está en la galaxia. And then the galaxy is in the universe and so on. Y así podríamos llegar. In something that is inside of a bigger place. Okay? Now, from and to are words that are connected. So, these are used to talk about a duration of something or the length of something that is between this space of time. Utilizamos de y para hablar de algo que está en un espacio de tiempo. The park hours are from 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. Okay, can you read it, please? ¿Lo pueden leer las dos? One, two, three.
Park hours are from
7 a.m.
to
9 p.m.
Exactly. That something has a duration. Algo tiene duración. Now, here we have another, but it's very similar. Between. Between is to talk about something that is happening inside of a period. Algo que tiene una duración dentro de un periodo. Call between 9 and 5. Llama entre 9 y 5. Can you read it, ladies, please? ¿Lo pueden leer?
Call between 9 and 5.
Fátima.
Falls between 9 and 5.
Okay. Okay, these are the use for on, in, from to, and between. Here we have the words at. Aquí tenemos las palabras at. We use at to talk about the hour of an event. At 5, for example, the class is at 11. We finish the class at 3. Or also we can use at to talk about a location. In this case, at the stadium. So we at has two uses. At for the time, at 5, at 2, in this case, at 5. And at also for a location, at the park, at the stadium. Or when you have a date, see you at Bibb's restaurant, see you at Galerías Acapulco, see you at, and the name of the place. Okay, can you read it, ladies, please? 1, 2, 3.
Concert at 5 p.m. at the stadium.
Well, concerts are the at 5 p.m. at the stadium.
Very good. At for the time and at for the location. Here we have the word truth. Repeat after me. Truth.
True.
Truth. The park is open Tuesday through Sunday. Read it after me. The park is open Tuesday through Saturday. Sunday, sorry.
The park is open Tuesday through Sunday.
The park is open Tuesday through Sunday.
It's also to tell about the idea that something is available these days or this period of the length of time. Para ver de algo que está disponible a través de estos días. Through open Tuesday, starting point, through Sunday, the finish point. Here is another use of the word on. We use on when we are talking about weekends. So on is used to talk about days on Monday, on Friday, and also for the weekends. There are free concerts on the weekends. We don't say in the weekends. We don't say at the weekend. We say on the weekends. Please repeat after me. There are free concerts on the weekends.
There are free concerts on the weekends.
Mm-hmm. There are free concerts on the weekends.
Thank you. And finally, again, at is used to talk about telephone numbers. You see, call the park office at, and then you give the telephone number. So for example, if you want to call me, I can say, oh, please call me at 744-178-6022. And I give you my telephone number using at, or maybe the office. Call me at the office at 555-62166, and so on. At is used to tell about telephone numbers and for express purpose. Y aquí la palabra for expresa propósito. For y more information. Para más información. So please repeat after me. Call the park office at 555-2400 for more information.
Call the park office at 555-2400 for more information.
Thank you. Fatima?
Call the park office at 555-2400 for information.
For more information. Any questions?
For more information.
About these prepositions, ¿alguna duda de estas preposiciones?
No escuché qué significaba true.
Través. O expresa una duración. The park is open Tuesday through Sunday. El parque está abierto de martes a domingo. De a. True. In this case, because we are using it to talk about the days that the park is open. Para hablar de los días que el parque está abierto. It is used for something in a space of time. Lo usamos para algo que está dentro de un espacio de tiempo. Through. A través de, you can use it through something. But here with days, through is like an expression de a. De lunes a domingo. De martes a jueves. ¿Ok? ¿Sí queda claro?
True. Yes, teacher.
So, for example, in the old schedule, en el anterior horario, we had classes Monday through Thursday. Teníamos clases de lunes a jueves. Do you remember that? ¿Se acuerdan?
Yes.
Monday through Thursday. Otra forma sería from Monday to Thursday. From to. También se puede utilizar. It's very similar. Any questions up to here? ¿Alguna pregunta hasta aquí?
No.
Okay. At 1 o'clock, we are going to have the break. A la una tenemos el break. And coming back, we are going to have the exam. Okay. Si no viene el maestro Mario, les dije que iba a venir el maestro Mario. I told you that we have a class for you, a special class. Sí les había comentado, ¿no? Que vamos a tener una clase especial. No me han avisado, pero lo más seguro es que a lo mejor no. So, we are going to go with the exam. Y entonces estaremos haciendo el examen. Any questions, ladies? ¿Alguna duda? ¿Alguna pregunta? ¿No? ¿Algún chisme? ¿No hay chismes?
El examen no lo podemos dejar para otra semana, teacher.
Déjame lo
pregunto. No sé, Fátima, no sé, Fátima. Igual ella ya, okay. Ya está preparada.
Are you ready, Fátima? Lo que sí podemos hacer es practicar. ¿Qué pasó, Fátima? Ibas a decir algo.
Iba a decir un chiste de momento, pero no.
¿Qué? ¿Ibas a decir qué, perdón?
Es que me dijo que sí, estaba lista y le voy a decir que no.
Oh, I need you to be ready. Necesito que estén listas. Miren, checkpoints. In your book,
tal vez.
In your book, there is a checkpoint from units 4 to 6. Vamos a hacerlo juntos. ¿Qué les parece?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, so this is like a practice, and let's do it. Let's try to do it before 1, and then we came back and practice a little bit more. Here it's like a little exam, and this is for us to practice. And you know, practice makes perfect. And here it's there are some exercises that are kind of easy. We are going to do it together. Vamos a hacerlos juntos, okay? Algunos ejercicios que son muy sencillos los vamos a ir haciendo juntos. Okay? Are you ready?
Ready, teacher.
Okay. It says that's not quite right. Which of these sentences are true for you? This is not a right question or a wrong or right. This is something that is only to refer for your options. For example, our English class is in the morning. True or false? Well, we start in the morning, so it's true. Number two, I never come to class late. True or false, Carolina, Fátima? Okay. That's good. Number three. We have classes 3 times a week.
False.
It's false because we have classes only on Saturdays. And number four. There are 30 students in this room, in this class.
False.
Okay, can you read number 5, Fatima?
There is a coffee break at 10:30 a.m.
True or false, Fatima?
False.
False. Carolina, number 6.
We had a lot of homework. True.
True. Did you have a lot of homework?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
So no, true. No, no.
False. 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 Okay. I never. Ah, this is true. This is true. Sorry. Let me erase this. This is never come late to class. We don't have 3 times. They're not starting. Okay. Number 7, Fatima, it's your turn.
The students sometimes eat in the class. True.
Fatima, okay. Carolina, number 8.
Our teacher drives a car to class. False,
I don't drive, I'm in my house. Number 9, Fatima.
Cell phone often read in class. False,
okay. And number 10, Carolina?
We go out to club after class.
We go out to a club after class.
False,
imagine that, Carolina. No, Fatima is really young. ¿Te imaginas? ¿Se ir a un club después de la clase? No. Here, the next exercise. It says, how much do you know about your partner? ¿Qué tanto conoces a tu compañero? Complete the sentences to make guesses about your partner. Guesses means tratar de adivinar. Then ask your partner questions to find out if you are right or wrong. For example, number 1. He or she or my partner doesn't read a lot of books. Mi compañera o mi compañero no lee muchos libros. Y aquí diríamos right or wrong. Por ejemplo, ¿qué opinas de Fátima? ¿Lee muchos libros o no lee muchos libros, Carolina? Ahí está Fátima.
Sí, lee muchos libros. Right.
Okay, pero okay, tú dices
she
reads a lot of books, ella lee muchos libros. Aquí lo que haríamos sería poner el verbo reads, de que ella lee, reads a lot of books. ¿Y tú qué dirías, Fátima? Right or wrong? ¿Ella está en lo correcto o está equivocada?
Right.
Ándale pues, muy bien. ¿Qué libros lees? No te voy a preguntar, ok. Ok, now, let's do number 2 for the teacher. Esto sería nada más para el profe. The news on TV every night. My partner watches, or the teacher watches the news on TV every night. Si se fijan, tuve que poner el verbo, ¿eh? Watches. Y como es afirmativo, reads o watches. Si lo hubiera puesto negativo, le hubiera puesto doesn't. ¿Doesn't qué? Watch. Que o sea que no ve las noticias en la tele cada noche. Ok. Entonces, ¿ustedes qué dicen? ¿Que sí veo o que no veo?
Watches.
¿Y tú qué dices, Fátima? Don't watch or watches.
Watches.
Y yo digo que están en lo correcto. Me gusta ver noticias. Ok. Para la 3 y la 4, vamos a adivinar de Fátima. Tú vas a hacerlo, Carolina. Y para la 5 y la 6... tú, Fátima, vas a adivinar de Carolina, ¿ok? Y vamos a ver si la atinaste. Ok, váyanle pensando. Dice, with his or her parents, con sus padres, de él o de ella, para Fátima. Number 4, an hour a day on the internet. Una hora al día. ¿Qué verbo sería aquí con sus padres? ¿Qué actividad pudiera hacer aquí esta? It, ok.
It.
It's. Sería it's. Y aquí, an hour a day on the internet. Una hora al día.
And go.
Go on.
On.
Go on. Y en la letra 5, Fátima, ¿cuál sería? At 6 a.m. on the weekends. ¿Qué actividad le pones a Carolina?
Go out.
Go out. O sea que ella sale a las 6 de la mañana de su casa. Ok, ya le hiciste madrugar. Ok, y tennis, very well. ¿Qué verbo sería aquel que hace falta?
Play.
Play o plays.
Plays.
Y aquí sería goes out. Y aquí sería plays. Ok. So these are the activities. Ok. Fátima eats with her parents. Fátima come con sus padres. Right or wrong, Fátima?
Right.
Ok. Go on an hour a day on the internet. Va. Se va una hora al día en el internet. Right or wrong?
Right.
Sí, yo diría que hasta más, pero bueno, ok. Ahora Carolina. Fátima says you go out at 6 a.m. on the weekends. Fátima dice que tú sales a las 10 de la mañana los fines de semana. Right or wrong?
Wrong.
Wrong, no, está bien dormidita, descansando. Carolina, Fátima dice que tú juegas tenis muy bien, plays tenis very well.
Right, pero ¿cómo se puede decir jugué?
Played en pasado.
¿Pasado sería?
De hecho, voy a hacer un comercial. Sí. El viernes de la semana que viene, me pidieron dar una clase acerca de los verbos en pasado. Todavía nosotros no los vemos, pero van a estar invitadas, van a estar mandando información. Entonces ahí les pido estar pendiente porque va a ser creo que de 6 a 8.
Okay.
El viernes. Ojalá puedan estar.
Yes, teacher.
Órale pues. Entonces aquí, bueno, nos hemos divertido sí. Un poquito aquí tratando de adivinar que Fátima come con sus papás y que Carolina se va bien temprano los fines de semana. ¿A dónde? ¿Quién sabe? Dice, how well do you know your city? Complete the chart, use the words to tell a partner 5 things about your city. Does your partner agree? Places in a city. Dice, lugares en una ciudad. I want you to name some places. Quiero que me nombren un lugar. Por ejemplo, un restaurante. ¿Cuál sería el nombre del restaurante?
Cebu.
Cebu Restaurant.
Cebu Restaurant.
How do you describe the place? ¿Cómo describirías el lugar? En este caso puede ser expensive.
Expensive.
Pretty.
And food.
Nice food.
Fusión. A ver, fusión de comida italiana.
Okay.
¿Cómo
se
dice?
A fusion of Italian food. ¿Y con cuál otra?
Mexican.
Ok. Mexican.
¿Existe aquí?
And Italian.
No es Italian, es
¿Hindú?
Hindú, sí, de la India.
India,
de la India. ¿Cómo se dice? Hindú.
A Mexican and Hindu
Mexican.
Fusion.
Fusion. Fusion.
A Mexican and Hindu. No, ahí está mal el an. Tiene que ser con de.
Mexican.
De. A Mexican and Hindu food fusion.
Oh.
Una fusión de comida mexicana e hindú.
Okay.
Se llama Cebu.
Cebu.
Sí lo he visto, está por la escénica.
La escénica.
Okay. Fátima, name a place that you like, un lugar que te guste. En Acapulco.
Es con temática de Harry Potter.
What's the name? ¿Cómo se llama?
El caldero de... no me acuerdo cómo se llama. El caldero de... Lo voy a buscar.
¿De qué? ¿El caldero mágico? No.
No, el caldero de este Wizard. Es...
Está en Acapulco, sí, mira, aquí está.
Sí.
¿Dónde estás?
Está por la quebrada, ¿no? ¿Sí estoy bien, Fátima?
Es café.
Sí.
¿Es este?
Sí.
Mira.
No lo había visto.
El Wizard's Coffee. Ah, how do you describe? Mira, aquí está una amiga mía que le gusta. How do you describe this place, Fátima? ¿Cómo describirías este lugar?
Aesthetic nice.
Nice. Nice aesthetic.
Nice aesthetic. Yes.
Okay. Es temático, ¿no? Es a sí. Team Café. Es un café temático. Muy bien.
¿Pero okay. Cómo se llamaba el que ahorita estaban diciendo? Me interesa un poco.
Cebu.
Cebu.
Cebu Restaurant. Vamos a ver si está por aquí. La verdad, nunca he ido.
No, se come rico.
Cebu Restaurant. Sí. Aquí está.
Ahí está.
Ahí está, mira. Ya hace hambre.
Sí.
Ah, oh, se ve muy bonito.
Sí. Disculpa, Carolina, ¿no es el que era el...
Sí.
¿Cómo se llama? ¿Miramar?
No sé, creo que tenía otro nombre, pero después lo compraron ahí y lo remodelaron. Es rico la comida.
Ajá. Pero da la vista a Puerto Marqués.
Sí, a Puerto Marqués. Sí. Si va uno en la noche, va todo oscuro, oscuro, oscuro. Pero
no, se no come. Es lo que yo pensaba. No, sí, se ve muy bonito. Sí, very sí. Nice place. Kind of natural.
Anotado.
Very good, Fatima. Okay. Now here, ask a question in two ways. Answer more than yes or no. Well, here we need to ask the second question. Aquí tenemos que hacer la segunda pregunta. This is from unit number 4. Esta es la por la unidad número 4. Por ejemplo, what's your neighborhood like? Usando I mean, do you like it? Number 2, how often do you text your friends? ¿Qué tan seguido le mandas mensaje a tus amigos?
¿Cómo dirías? I mean, do you have friends?
Esa es una buena pregunta. I mean, do you have friends? O do you have cell phone? O I mean, what is your cell phone? Number 3, what kind of sports do you watch on TV?
Sports Center.
Okay, but you need to ask the second question. Pero necesitas escribir la segunda pregunta. Por ejemplo, sería I mean, do you like sports? ¿Te gustan los deportes? What time do you get up on the weekends? I mean, do you work? Do you wake up early? Do you wake up late? Porque ¿a qué horas te levantas en fin de semana? ¿Te levantas temprano? ¿Te levantas tarde? Es lo que queremos saber.
Ok.
Number 5. Who does the laundry at your house? The second question. I mean,
Do you laundry on the house? O sea, ¿qué?
Do you do the laundry? Así quedaría. I mean, do you do the laundry? Quiero decir, ¿lavas tú la ropa? I mean, do you do the laundry?
O se lava en la casa porque algunos llevan su ropa a la tintorería.
Uh-huh. I mean, do you take the laundry to a laundromat? ¿Llevas la ropa sucia a una lavandería? Más o menos así que está un poco larga, pero así es. I mean, do you take your laundry to a laundromat? ¿Llevas tu ropa sucia a una lavandería? Todo esto sería una posible también. Okay. Now, find the words. For example, here, these are different TV shows. Cartoon. Number two, what is the number two?
Who's Mega?
Mm-hmm. Well, here the words are scrambled. Las letras están revueltas. Otronac quiere decir cartoon. Mega Was is a name of other show. Es un nombre de otro programa. ¿Cómo sería? Sería...
Game show.
Exacto, game show. Number three?
Sitcom.
Sitcom. Number four?
Talk show.
Talk show. Number five?
Soap opera.
Soap opera. Number six? Les voy a ayudar con una. The article. Ay, esa era la palabra que hace rato no encontraba. Article. A and an articles. The is another article. The
news.
The news. Number. Well, the next one is
reality show.
Reality show. And finally,
documentary.
Documentary. Yes. Okay, now, what's your routine? Complete each question with a verb. Can you think of four more questions? Then ask your partner. For example, what time do you have breakfast? What time do you... What is the verb missing? ¿Cuál es el verbo aquí?
Go.
Go. Exactly. What time do you go to work or class? Home at night.
Go.
Mm-mm. Go es cuando te vas. Cuando llegas es come. Come home.
Come.
Igual las pueden ir anotando. Y when do you? When do you time with your family?
Spend.
Very good. Number, well, the next one. When do you out with your friends?
Go.
Go out with your friends. When do you to the movies?
See. See to the movies?
No. Go también.
Go.
¿Cuándo vas al cine? What time? When do you? How often do you at the gym? How often? ¿Qué tan seguido? How often do you exercise at the gym?
Exercise.
How often do you the subway or the bus?
The subway or the bus?
Take the bus or take the soap. How often do you your email?
Check.
Right.
Check.
How often? ¿Qué tan seguido? Where do you? It's asking about places. Where do you your homework? Les voy a ayudar. Do. Where, donde haces tu tarea? Where do you do your homework? Shopping, where do you?
Do you go shopping?
Go shopping, exactly. Where do you lunch?
Eat lunch?
Eat lunch, épale. Yes, eat lunch.
Lunch, go
shopping. Okay. And that's it. Eso fue todo. Regresando del break, vamos a verlo acá. ¿Sale? Aquí tenemos the recording of the session. And here is the checkpoint for this course. Now, here are many, many exercises so we can practice about our understanding of English. This is checkpoint number exercise one from units 4 to 6. And here it says, read, that's not correct. Look at Sam's diary. Read the sentence as and choose true or false. Here we have an schedule, a diary about this person named Sam and some activities that he does during the week. So we need to choose true or false depending on the activities that he does. For example, number one, it says, Sam has Spanish class 3 times a week. The answer is already here, Don, because Sam has 3 times a week Spanish class. So we need to find Spanish. And it's 1 and 2, not 3 times a week. What about English class every morning? Sam has English class every morning. Here is in the morning.
False.
False. No class on Wednesday. On Thursday is in the afternoon, so it's false. What about number 3? Sam never has class in the afternoon.
False,
because he has classes. Yes. Sam has math class on Wednesday morning.
False.
Really?
Wednesday?
Math class on Wednesday morning. Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 10 a.m. True or false? No, it's true. Sí tiene clases miércoles en la mañana, 10 a.m.
Oh, yeah. Sí.
Math. Number 4. Sam has math class. This is number 4. Sorry, number 5. On Tuesdays, lunch starts at 12 p.m.
False.
On Tuesday. False, because on Tuesday, the lunch starts at 1. Number 6, Sam goes to soccer practice at 3 p.m. on Mondays. Soccer practice, 3 p.m. on Mondays.
True.
True, it is true. Monday, 3 p.m. soccer. Sam classes starts at 9 every day. True or false?
False.
Every day. False. There's no classes on Friday.
True.
True. No classes on Friday. Very good. Let's check the answers. All correct. Very good. Next exercise. Here, what you need to do is to write the negative form to make the sentences negative. For example, here, Sam doesn't have Spanish class 3 times a week. This is the affirmative. On Tuesdays, lunch starts at 12:30 p.m. Now we need to turn this sentence into the negative. How do we do this? On Thursday lunch, we need to add the negative with doesn't. And we need to change the verb from starts to the normal base form of the verb. So on Tuesday's lunch, doesn't start at 12:30. Let's check the answers. The answer is correct. I want you to help me with the other answers, please. This number two is done. What about number three? What is the negative for our English class is in the morning? What is the negative?
Our English class doesn't.
Now, check here, Carolina. We are using the verb to be in affirmative. So you need to use the verb to be in the negative. Is affirmative.
Is not.
Or isn't.
Isn't.
Our English class isn't in the morning. Now here we don't have the verb to be. Our teacher drives a car to class. What is the negative for this?
Our teacher is not.
No. Take a look at. No. Now.
Don't drive.
Don't drive is our teacher, third person.
Doesn't drive.
What's the difference here? ¿Cuál es la diferencia? One is with the verb to be, and the other is not with the verb to be. Doesn't, here, like this one. Here we have the verb to be. Now, there is a coffee break at 10:30 a.m. Again, we have the verb to be here. Be careful. What is the negative?
There isn't.
Exactly.
There isn't
a coffee break. Very good. Number six, we have now the negative.
We aren't.
Mm-mm. There is no verb. No hay ningún verbo to be ahí. We have. What's the negative for we have? ¿Cuál es el negativo?
We don't have.
Exactly. We don't have.
Okay.
When you have the verb be, you change the be from affirmative to negative. But when there is another verb, like eat, like drive, you need to use the auxiliary does or doesn't, or do or don't. Number seven, the students eat in class.
Don't eat.
The students don't eat in class. Number eight, we go out for lunch after class.
We don't,
excellent.
We don't go
out for lunch. And you see, all the sentences are correct. Great job now for you too. Let's continue, there are more exercises. Remember, this checkpoint is for us to practice. Here. How much do you know about Susie? Read about Susie and then check true or false. Here is the reading about Susie. It says, I want you guys to help me read this. I'm going to read from here to here, and you are going to read the second. I will tell you when to read, okay? Carolina and Fatima, I will tell you when to start reading. Okay. So this is about Susie, and this is also about answering true or false about these statements. Susie lives with her parents is already answered with a false. Stays in bed, reads a lot of book, watches the news on TV, and Susie plays tennis. Here goes, it says, Susie doesn't live with her parents. She lives in an apartment with her friends. Carolina.
She get up early during the week, but on the weekend she get up at 10 a.m.
Very good, Fatima.
She doesn't.
Here.
In here. In her free time, she reads a lot of books. She doesn't have a TV, but she listens to the news on the radio every day.
Very good. Carolina?
She plays a lot of tennis and usually spends an hour a day on the internet.
Okay. Now let's check the information. Number one, number two, well, number one is that Susie lives with her parents. No, Susie doesn't live. Susie stays in bed late on weekends. True or false? Check the information. Here is the answer. Check the answer. Susie stays in bed late on weekends. No, true or false? It says, look at, she gets up early during the week, but on the weekends, she gets up at 10 a.m.
True.
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 Number three, Susie reads a lot of books.
True.
True. Number four, Susie watches the news on TV.
False.
False, because she doesn't have a TV. Susie plays tennis.
True.
True. It's right here. She plays a lot of tennis. Check the answers. All correct. Very good. All the information is here. Let's continue. We have more exercises about Susie. It says, match Susie's responses with the correct questions. There is an extra response. So only one is incorrect. The others are for the questions. For example, number one, do you live with your parents? No, I don't. But I visit them every weekend. What about number two? Do you stay in bed late on the weekends?
Yes, I do. Well, usually.
Exactly. Number three, do you read a lot of books?
Yes, I do. I read in the evening.
Number four, do you watch news on TV?
No, I don't. I don't have TV.
Very good. And finally, do you play any sports?
Yes, I do play. I play tennis.
Exactly. Very good. Where is Fatima? She's missing in action. Okay, now here is about places. How well do you know your city? Use the words from the box to complete the chart. Places in a city. What are some places that you can find in a city?
A school.
A school.
A school, museum.
Museum, yes.
Museum. Park.
A park.
Mall.
A mall, yes.
Cafe.
A cafe. Now, the others are words that describe places. Those are adjectives.
Nice,
yes. What means nice? Nice is bonito.
Mm-hmm.
Convenient. What is convenient?
Caro. Expensive.
Caro. Boring. ¿Qué es boring?
Aburrido.
Cheap.
Barato.
Barato. Small.
Pequeño.
Small cafe. Very good. Let's check the answers. It's just to put the words in the correct column. Places and descriptions. All these are adjectives. Adjectives that describe places. Here, another exercise. How well you know your city? Choose there is or there are to complete the sentences. Number one is an example. There are a couple of expensive restaurants in our neighborhood. Number two. There's or there are?
There are.
There are? Okay, that was for Carolina. Number three is for Fatima.
There are.
There are. Number four, Fatima? No, Carolina?
There is.
There's, very good. A big mall, number five.
There is.
There's, very good. And finally, number six.
There are.
There are. Very good. Let's check the answers. All correct. Very good. Great job, Fatima and Carolina. Very good job. Let's see the next exercise here. Remember, we are reviewing what we learned. So here, this is what we did in the units checkpoints with the book. Now is ask a question in two ways. When there are more answers, okay. Here, for example, what's your neighborhood like? I mean, do you like it? Number two, this is similar from the book. How often do you text your friends?
I mean, do you text a lot?
Exactly. Number three, what do you do on your computer?
I mean, do you spend a lot of time on the internet?
Very good, Fatima. Number four. What time do you get up on the weekends? On weekends.
I mean, do you get up later?
Late. Very good. What exercise do you do?
I mean, do you go to the gym?
Go to the gym. Yes. Number six. How often do you go out?
I mean, do you go to clubs?
Mm-hmm. Very good. Number seven. What kinds of sports do you watch on TV?
I mean, do you watch soccer games?
Exactly. And finally, who does the laundry at your house?
I mean,
do you wash your own clothes? Very good. Next exercise. Okay, are you the same or different? Now, what is the word for this one, remember? Cartoon was number one. Number two? Exactly. Game show. Number three.
Cosmo.
Sitcom.
Sitcom.
Okay. Number four.
Oswald.
Talk show.
Talk show. Very good. Number five.
Oprah. Opera.
The first word is soap. Soap opera. Number six.
The news.
Exactly, the news. Number seven.
Reality show.
Reality show, yes. And finally, documentary. Okay. Different types of programs. Okay, now are you the same or different? Read the sentences and choose the correct responses. I sometimes watch cartoons.
Me too.
Me too. I often watch game shows.
Me too.
Me too. I don't like sitcoms.
I neither.
Me neither.
Me neither. I never watch talk shows.
Me neither.
Me neither. I sometimes watch soap operas.
Me too.
Me too. I never watch the news.
Me neither.
I don't like reality shows.
Me neither.
And finally, I don't like documentaries.
Me neither.
Me neither. Very good. Next exercise, number three.
I never
watch a
cartoon.
It says, are you the same? Complete the conversation using the sentences from the box. I never watch cartoons.
I love cartoons.
Exactly. Really? Using really is like, de veras, en serio, neta? Like, like giving the opposite answers. You don't believe it. Number two, I always watch the news in the morning.
Really? I watch the news in the evening.
Very good. Number three, I can't stand soap operas. Can't stand is negative. I can't stand, no lo soporto. I can't stand soap operas.
Really? I want the every day?
I watch them every day, yes. Oops, right here. And finally, I hate reality shows.
Really? I sometimes watch reality show on the weekends.
Exactly. Very good. Okay, now here, what's your routine? It says, complete the questions with the correct verbs. It's very similar as the one we did from the books. Number one, what time do you breakfast?
What do you do?
One time, exactly.
Eat.
Number two, what time do you to work or class?
Take.
Go.
Walk.
Number three, what time do you home at night?
Come.
Now, the question, when do you? When do you?
Spend.
Time, exactly, spend. When do you out with your friends?
Go.
Go. When do you do the movies?
Go.
Exactly. Now, with how often means, ¿qué tan seguido? How often at the gym?
Exercise.
Exactly. How often the subway or the bus?
Take.
Exactly. How often do you your email?
Check.
Exactly. And now where do you that talks about a place? Where do you?
Do you homework.
Do your homework. Where do you?
Go.
Go shopping. And finally, where do you eat lunch? Excellent. Well, it was very similar from the one. Now, what's your routine? We need to match the correct answers with the questions. For example, number one, what time do you have breakfast? I usually have breakfast around 7 o'clock, usually to talk about frequency, okay, remember? We have usually, never, often, and so on. Number two, it says, when do you go out with your friends?
What? I usually go on weekend night.
Okay, that's a good one, yes. Number two, how often do you go to the gym?
I go to the gym twice a week.
Twice a week, meaning two opportunities. Okay. What time do you get home at night?
I get home at about 7:30.
Exactly. Where do you go shopping?
I always go to the mall.
Very good. When do you go to the movies?
We often go on the weekends.
Okay, we have a problem. When do you go out with your friends? And I usually go on the weekends. Maybe here we are in a mistake. Let's check number seven. Where do you eat lunch?
I often go to cafe in the neighborhood.
Very good. And finally, how often do you check your email? I always check it in the morning. So I guess number four, six and number two are incorrect. Okay, let's correct the answers here, and the other one, let's put it on the correct place. Here it goes, and now we are correct. Very good. Let's continue with the practice. Oh, that was it. I think we finished because now we are in unit number 7. Let me go back a little bit. Let's see if we don't have any other exercise here. Yes, we have another. Oh, that was the last one. Okay, we finished our review from the checkpoint. Let's check this activity. I guess we have some exercises missing here. I guess it was exercise number 2. Yes. It says ask a question in 2 ways. We did that. Ya la hicimos esta, ¿no?
Yeah.
Sí, la hicimos. Yes, let's see what is missing here.
No marco.
But we finished. Okay, well, that's it for units numbers 5 to 6. Now is the opportunity to ask some questions if you need to. No sé si tengan alguna duda, alguna pregunta. We finished the checkpoint. We finished units 4, 5, and 6. I don't know if you have any questions for these units. Let's review a little bit fast about what we learned from unit number 4, 5, and 6. Okay, it's not correct. Well, my PowerPoint is not working. I have to reinitiate it again.
Teacher, yo tengo una pregunta.
Yes, of course.
Cuando uno dice there are a couple of, uh-huh. es cuando estamos hablando en plural, pero para cosas nada más.
Could be things, could be people. Also, there are a couple of friends. Okay. Hay un par de amigos.
Okay.
So you can use it with people. You can use it with things or even animals. There are a couple of dogs, something like that. A couple, you can use it with many things, inclusive, including person or people. Okay. Any other question?
No, teacher, thank you.
Okay, let's see from unit number 4, everyday life, describing the typical morning, describing routines, yes, no questions about activities during the week. Say more than yes or no to sound friendly. Use well to give you time to think. And also reading from a magazine or an article about American habits. Here, how to answer what's your typical day like with different routines that we do every day. Wake up, get up, take a shower. These are our routines, maybe in the morning. And also remember, we practice a little bit the pronouns with the third person, he, she, or it, the ways we change the verb. In general, we add an S to most verbs, but if the verb ends in a Y, we remove the Y and we add IES. So study becomes studies. Cry cries, try tries, and so on. This is for third person only, he, she, or it. And some verbs ending in O, SH, CH, X, or double S, we need to add only ES. For example, go, goes, do, does, wash, washes, watch, watches, mix, mixes, and kiss, kisses. And we also watched a video about the explanation with more rules about third person. We learned how to practice and say more than yes or no with phrases to sound more friendly and to use well to give you time to think. Time to think about the answer that you are giving. Well, my friend is here, my friend. Also, we learn a new word that is average, means promedio. So average is not too good, not too high, not too low, not too bad. Average, not poor, not good, in the middle. In unit number 5, we talked about free time, activities also that you like to do, and ask questions. Information questions with what, where, when, how often, remember? Say how often you do things and talk about different programs. Ask questions in two ways, to be not too direct, but to sound friendly also, and use I mean to give more ideas. Finally, in lesson D, we read an article about technology addicts. And, well, we practice how to send an email in the blog. Free time activities, things that you like to do. These are not obligations. These are things that you can use or you can do when you are using your free time. Surf the internet, play an instrument, go shopping, play a sport. And, well, we learn how to use the word how often to ask about frequency. How often do or how often does when we use a third person. These are the adverbs of frequency that we learn. Some of them are for 100% of the time, like always. And never, well, happens 0%. No, it doesn't happen. So never means negative, that you don't do an activity. And, well, there are like percentages of how often they occur. Always, all the time, usually, almost 100%, normally, often, sometimes, occasionally, seldom, hardly ever, or never. How often is the question to ask about the frequency. For example, how often do you brush your teeth? And we learn words to talk about occasions that we do something. Once means one occasion. Twice, two occasions, maybe a day, a week, a month, a year. And when we are having more than two occasions, we say the number of occasions that occurs and adding the word times. So for one occasion, you say once. For two occasions, you say twice. But for three or four or five or more occasions, you say the number and times. For example, three times, four times, five times, and so on, depending how often you do the time. We don't say why one time. One time is incorrect. We don't say two times. Two times is incorrect. The correct is once. The correct is twice. We also use words to link ideas, like and. And is a word that joins two ideas. For example, I like apples. That's an idea. But I need to join another thing. I use bananas, so here and is like the joining part. It links similar ideas. I like apples and bananas, but introduces an idea that is contrasting. Maybe sometimes a negative idea. For example, I like apples, but introduces a negative idea. I don't like bananas. And finally, our lesson six, we learn about how to describe the neighborhood using there is and there are's, how to tell the time and ask questions with what time, make suggestions with let's, and say me too or me neither to show that we have things in common, and say right and I know for things that we agree. Here is there is and there are. There is with only one thing, there are for two things or more, plural, singular and plural. A lot of is a quantifier that you can use when you are, referring to a large quantity, a big amount of things. Some, when there are not many, it's a little or a few, not many things. And a couple, when you're referring to two, up to five things. A couple, you can use them when you have two things, or up to five. Then also we learn about the adjectives, how to write them in a word, in a sentence, use them before nouns. We say the beautiful house, not the house beautiful. Adjectives, they come before the nouns they describe. And also we learn how to use these words, a lot of, some, a couple, the articles a or an, and if there are no things, we use the word no. Some practice. Finally, we learn how to use me too or me neither when we are having the same idea. I like dogs, me too. I don't like cats, it's a negative, me neither, but we have the same idea. One thing is for something positive, me too, and me neither when the idea is negative. Okay. I don't know if you have any questions, Carolina, because Fatima just left.
No, teacher.
Okay. So maybe we can, I'm going to give you the link for the exam. So you can go there and check about the exercises.